Balibago National High School is one of the largest public schools in the city of Santa Rosa. It has more than 5,000 students as of 2017. Among all grade level, grade 7 has the biggest population coming from different public school and private elementary school not only in the city of Santa Rosa but also in other provinces. The CIP has conducted survey and interview among grade 7 students for the following reasons. Number 1. Students from different places have different culture. Number 2. Assess their individual accomplishments, needs, and wants. Number 3. Help them to cope up with their transition from elementary to secondary. The project titled Matuto is based on the wants and needs of the students who need remediation in the four basic operations in mathematics. Only 108 out of 304 sampling grade 7 students are numerate in terms of four basic operations. The continuous improvement methodology of Matuto is composed of the assessment stage. Step 1, getting organized. Step 2, talk to customers. Step 3, walk the process. Step 4, identify improvement areas. The analyze stage is for the step 5 to do root cause analysis. Step 6, develop solutions. Step 7, finalize improvement plans. And for the act stage, we have the step 8, pilot solution. Step 9, rollout solution. And step 10, check the progress. The assessment stage, getting organized for step 1. Step 2, talk to customers. Step 3, walk the process. Step 4, identify improvement areas. For the implementation plan, we diagnose students based on the four fundamental operations in mathematics. We also conducted focus group discussion, preparation for Matuto launching, and the implementation. The subtests for the following are set up diagnostic test, then profiling of test results. The subtests for focus group discussion are the following: preparation of interview guide and survey form, accomplishment of survey form, reflections of the survey result in CI, and the subtests for preparation for Matuto launching are the following. First one, writing to the parents. Number 2, drafting the MOU. Number 3, program with parent. Number 4, preparation of the materials. And number 5, preparation of new schedule. For the subtests under implementation are the following. First, remediation. Number 2, evaluation. Number 3, result of evaluation or profiling. And number 5, evaluation of progress. Right after the implementation, the following are the results. The reward and recognition, the Matuto process, the second, third, and for the fourth quarter. And the last one is the preparation of materials for the second run. The anticipated problems during the planning are, first, the incomplete attendance during the remediation. Second, inconsistency of teachers and school head in the program. Number 3, unavailability of learning materials. Number 4, weather disturbances causes of the interruption of classes. Number 5, conflict of schedule among remediation teachers. For the step 1, getting organized, all team members map the overall process of the Matuto program. The step 2, talk with your customers. There was a meeting and orientation of the students. For the voice of the customers, these are their needs. Some of the students says that they need extra time to study and learn math. For some, they still need quality learning materials in math. For the ones, the students agree that they want extra time in studying math. Some are, they want to answer questions with peers. For some other needs, they stated that they need a dedicated teacher in math and they still need to be guided while learning. For once, They want kind teacher as well as they wanted to use calculator and computer. They also need to increase their grades in math. And they also cited that they still want to learn or need to learn multiplication. Some says that they want to learn math with music. And some other wanted to have quizzes or exercises daily. Step 3, walk-in presses. The supplier, which are the grade 7 teachers, the input, which are the worksheets, PowerPoint, video lessons, and modules. For the process, we have the preparation, remediation, distribution, test proper, retrieving, checking, evaluation of results of remediation, identifying mastered list and mastered skills, as well as the preparation of new materials or reinforcement. The outcome, 10 out of 304 or 2% of the grade 7 students will continue to remediate after the end of the school year. And the customers are the grade 7 students. Step 4, identifying the improvement areas. Number 1, problem solving in the 4 fundamental operations, specifically the division and multiplication. Number 2, analyzing and solving worded problems. Number 3, incomplete attendance of student participants. Number 4, venue of remediation due to inadequacy of vacant classrooms. For the analyze stage, we have the root cause analysis. Step 6, which is to develop solutions. And number 7, finalize improvement plans. For the step 5, root cause analysis, we have the non-numerates, which are the main causes. As we are after the analyzation, are the family problem, absenteeism, and numerical oppression. For the family problem, they stated that lack of parental guidance is one of the major causes, and at the same time, the financial problem and broken family. They also cited that the main cause of absenteeism is a student's financial problem, lack of interest. And for the numerical oppression, they stated that it's called TILA. For the lack of parental guidance, most of them are the main reasons are they have working parents, and the other parents are illiterate. The other one is unemployment, and at the same time for absenteeism, we also have a poor health condition. For step 6, develop solutions. You were able to develop the following. Number 1, strict monitoring attendance in remedial classes. Number 2, communicate with the parents. Number 3, adopt a child. 4, secured materials for the program. 5, approved schedule for remediation. Number 6, assurance of parent support. Number 7, 100% commitment of CI team. Number 8, 100% support of school head. For the step 7, finalize improvement plans. We have the activity chart for the initial implementation of the plan or within the process. For test 1, we diagnose students for profiling. Under sub-tests are the following. Set up diagnostic test. Persons in charge, Imelda Villarena, the grade 7 math teacher. And the rest of the grade 7 math teachers. Target date, September 6, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Next one, profiling of test results. Under the jurisdiction of Ms. Gemma B. Manzanero, Ms. Imelda B. Arena, and Ms. Liana E. Swellio. Target date, September 10, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Task 2, focus group discussion. Under sub-tests are the following. Set up diagnostic test. Persons in charge, Ms. Imelda B. Arena and the rest of the grade 7 math teachers. Target date, September 6, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Another one, guided accomplishment of survey forms by the students. Persons in charge, Gemma B. Manzanero, Imelda B. Arena, Liana E. Swallow. Target date, September 7, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Next subtask, reflection of the survey. Persons in charge, Gemma B. Manzanero, Imelda B. Arena, and Ms. Liana E. Swalyu. Target date, September 8, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Another one, getting the voice of the customers. Persons in charge, the grade 7 teachers. Target date, September 12, 2017. Remarks accomplished. The task 3, productivity charge within the process. Subtask, writing and informing the parents. Persons in charge, Ms. Imelda B. Arena and the rest of the grade 7 net teachers. Target date, September 8, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Next one, drafting the MOU. Persons in charge, Ms. Gemma B. Manzanero, Ms. Imelda B. Arena, and Ms. Liana E. Swalyu. Target date, September 8, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Third subtask, prepared new schedule. Persons in charge, Gemma B. Manzanero, Imelda B. Arena, Liana E. Swalyu. Target date, September 9, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Fourth one, preparation of the materials to be used for Project Matutu. Persons in charge, Imelda B. Arena, and the rest of their grade 7 MOT teachers. Target date, September 10, 2017. Remarks accomplished. For the act stage, we have the Step 8, pilot solution. Step 9, rollout solution. Step 10, check progress. For the task 4 under the implementation of Project MOT-22, we have the subtask for initial run or remediation. Persons in charge, Ms. Imelda B. Arena and the rest of the grade 7 math teachers. Target date, September 4 to October 20, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Letter B, evaluation of progress observation under the jurisdiction advisor of Ms. Gemma B. Manzanero, Ms. Imelda B. Arena, and Ms. Liana E. Swalyu. Target date, November 28, 2017. Remarks accomplished. Subtest, report on progress. Persons in charge, Gemma B. Manzanero, Imelda B. Arena, and Ms. Liana E. Swalyu. Target date, December 4, 2017. Remarks accomplished. The step 9, rollout solutions. Students will be enumerated with the 4 fundamental operations in mathematics. The teacher says the students during remedial lessons. Step 10, check in progress. Present accomplishment. The figure 1 graph shows the score of the students in the first test, in which out of 304 students, 196 students or 64% passed, while 108 students or 36% failed. Figure 2 shows that the score of the students in the second test, in which out of 108 students, 59 students or 55% passed, while 49 students or 45% failed. Figure 3 shows the score of the students in the third test, in which out of 14 students, 31 students of 63% passed, while 18 students or 31% failed. Thank you very much for listening.